I think you gave a really good explanation about the idea of suffering and the natural process involved in the idea of manifestation. But on a practical level, with the news media being 24 hours and instant news from around the world, you see all this happening quite often. And quite frankly, it's very overwhelming for a lot of teenagers and children who are trying to make sense of the world they live in. Can you give them some tips on how to overcome that and kind of still focus on the more, have a more focused life in the achieve, or a kind of more peaceful life? What kind of tips can you give them?
Look, majority human beings are immune. Majority human beings, they just look at the, flick the news. Okay, there was a disaster, plane crash. Oh yeah, these 100 people crying. Okay, interesting. Flick the news channel. For vast majority human beings, it doesn't have any effect. But there are always, in the human kingdom, there are always very sensitive individuals who are stirred up, who really feel for the destitute, for the people who are, you know, suffering. They feel for it. The only thing I say is a very good sign, because you feel affinity for the human beings or the life forms. It's a wonderful thing, because you are now sensitive enough to recognize your oneness with the greater living kingdom. Is there protection? There is no protection. How can I protect? If you really feel for somebody, how can I say stop feeling for somebody, just become immune, become like a Teflon, and it shouldn't affect you? I can't do that. That shows your true nature is linked up with the living king, other living things, and so be it. I'll tell you some stories. You know, in the story of Buddha or in the story of Vivekananda, we find this example. One day, Vivekananda, this great master philosopher, was talking about high philosophy, and one of the other disciples walked in. He said, Girish Babu, his name. He said, do you want me to show you the weakness of this man? He told the other disciples, Vivekananda. He said, how can he have weakness? He looked at Vivekananda and said, I just have one question for you. What has your Vedas done for these millions of Hindus suffering today? Look, can't be more blunt than that. Because in his time, also even today's time, 30-40% of the population of India do not have clean drinking water. What has the Vedas done for them? Ask him, what a blunt smack in the face. And this is true, he said it. And the moment he said it, this great Vivekananda, the master, turned into a little baby and started weeping. Real story, started weeping, crying like a baby. You see, the sensitivity here for the greater living kingdom becomes visible. It's not just some, master, I'm very clever, look at me, I'm so clever, clock. He actually feels. One of the great things Vivekananda said is this, brethren, do you feel for the greater humanity? Then you will do some good. If you don't have that feeling, you don't feel unhappy when somebody else is being hurt. If you don't have that feeling, brethren said, these are his words, brethren, do you feel? If you feel for others, the pain of the others, you are ready for work. You will do it. You can't help yourself, so you will give your life away for the betterment of others. And this is what happens to all the great masters. And when a youngster is sensitive enough to feel like, I said, he's blessed, he'll pay a price. Of course, he's going to keep shuddering all the time. But he's actually linked up with greater humanity. So in his life, he will not just live for his own little family and his own personal, well-being. He'll look for the greater well-being. It's a sign of a very developed individual when they suffer like that.